got some heat for you today. This is our new guest.
Rudolph III, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, we're kind of doing an impromptu live event right now. Our live showing in the dungeon, apparently. And yeah, I met this fella right to the left of me just now, a few minutes ago, and this other guy at the library, and we've been trying to hook up ever since we met, and today's the day.
Basically, we've been making heat, man. I don't know, man. I've been gone for a minute, can't lie. I've been busy, man, but you know what I mean? Darth Vader's back in the flesh, you know what I mean? Black Samson, I got some heat for you. Check out my Reverb Nation, Darth Vader, or you can check it out at Underground Records, you know, the main page and whatnot. Yeah, man, we're just here trying to cook up some heat, so.
Do you have any questions to ask me about what I'm gonna do, or maybe as an artist or something?
Yeah, basically, tell the fans, like, what your top five artists are in the game right now.
Hip-hop or music in general?
Yeah, like, what inspired you to do, like, music?
Well, basically, when I was young, I used to have the Fisher-Price recorder and try to be an interviewer. And then I always, as a kid, just instinctively took out the pots and pans, started beating with them and dancing MC Hammer, because that was big, and then Vanilla Ice and everything. So it got into music, as I always had a natural enjoyment of it, and I had natural rhythm. And then it was cheaper for me at the time to, how should I put it, like get the pen and the pad, as opposed to buying a saxophone and waking up early and going to like band class and everything like that. So it was kind of just a natural progression from my story writing, which led into creative writing and poetry, and then it was just a simple progression into songwriting. And then songwriting started off with rap, and then everyone needed hooks because no one could get hooks or people to do them properly. So then I ended up practicing singing, and then before you know it, I could hold a note for an extended period of time and do, you know, low notes and mid-range notes. And so that's how I kind of got into music, my love. And then later on, it was like I had a purpose with it. When I started inspiring people and doing songs about recycling and songs about hope, and I'm like, well, I don't need to go down the gangster route, or I don't need to wear a bandana to prove a point. You know, I can be my own authentic self and wear what I want and go with a message because it's rocking the crowd. Now I just need to, you know, moving forward, get into the promoters, you know, digging my vibe. And then I was like, well, I don't drink, I don't swear. It's like, what fun am I? Listen to the song, press play, and then you'll see what fun it is. And then I used to rock out the whole crowd in the middle of the pandemic. Didn't matter, you know, that's how over I was. But the same promoters were like, no thanks. They wouldn't give me 2 seconds, so. And then the top five people in music, I would say right now, or that I like, with my top favorite musician, has to be Frank Sinatra right up there. And then I also like Dolly Parton and Lenny Kravitz. Lenny Kravitz is a big favorite of mine because he's really about the love and about, you know, being creative and wearing the cool outfits. And then Stevie Wonder, of course, I really like. And just more classic stuff, you know, Bruce Springsteen. My mom liked Lionel Richie and Rod Stewart, so all those classic stuff. And then I like country music, like Bill Bigtown and Carrie Underwood. And then as far as rappers, I would definitely have to say KRS-One is probably up there. As far as like not just what he does lyrically, but like and musically, but he does in the community. He goes to school and he puts on like TED Talks about hip hop and how it's good for the culture and people get into. Then he also does like rapping seminars. So he goes online and he just says, okay, well, tips on how to be a better rapper, a freestyler, some of the business side from his 20 plus years of doing it. And then I'd have to say, obviously, LL Cool J is another one. He's been able to transition from, you know, I Need Love and something with his, I forget the song, but it's I Need the Radio.